Oh, hello there. I was just working on this new method of controlling your router with your mind. Here's how you can do it as well. First, you need to get grounded. Then you need to align all your chakras. Then you empty your mind and you begin to visualize the exact CLI command that you want your router to execute. And once you can see the command, you can feel it, you can taste it, you'll know that you are ready. And you can pull out your phone and enter that exact CLI command in a Telegram chat. Press send and your router will execute that command magically. Now, this is possible thanks to Telegram offering their users to create bots completely for free. These bots reside on their server, so as long as their server is up, you can take advantage of them. These bots can be controlled through an HTTP-based API, and each bot has a unique access token. So as long as you have a device that is capable of making HTTP requests, it can send and receive messages on the behalf of this bot. And in RouterOS, we can do that through the use of tool fetch. So essentially, as long as your router has access to the internet and you have access to your Telegram account, you can control your router from anywhere in the world. In fact, you and the router can be at the opposite ends of the globe. Now, you could set this up and do this entirely from your phone, but I've installed a Telegram desktop application to make things a little bit easier. So the first thing you need to do is find this user named Botfather. It has this bot icon on the left and a check mark to the right. By chatting with this bot, you can create your own bots. Type /help to see all the things that it can do. So let's use this new bot command to create our own bot. Okay, so now you need to name it. I'm just gonna name it MikroTik bot. And now the important thing is we need to give it essentially a handle. MikroTik bot. Obviously somebody's already using this. So let me name it MikroTik 456 bot. Okay, this username was available and a bot was created. So next step is to copy its access token and to make our first API request. I've saved two most important API commands in this text file. Number one, we got get updates, and number two, we got send message. So we're just gonna use these two today. And to make them work, I need to replace this little gap with my token. Okay, so now I'm gonna copy the get updates API message. And I'm just gonna enter that into my browser. Okay, so we get something, but there's no messages yet, so we're not getting any updates. So let me just open the chat to my bot and send it a message. Now, if I refresh this API command, you can see that I've received an update. It has an update ID, which we're gonna later use to track the messages that we've already read. And then there is an ID of whom this message is from. So in this case, this is my Telegram unique ID. And then there's also the chat ID, which in the case of private messages is just the other user's personal ID. If I copy this ID, I can now send a reply from my router. Okay, so let me open a terminal to my router and we're gonna use the tool fetch command. Okay, do URL equals And now in this other API command, there was another space there actually, after chat ID. So this is where I'm gonna paste my user ID. And then at the end, there's this text bit. I'm just gonna type your bot at your service. Okay, now I can paste this. And I also add another flag which says output user. If you don't add this output user, a text file with the return message will be saved on your router, and you probably don't want that. Okay, so that was successful. If I now open the Telegram chat, the message I just sent from my router is there. And we could already use this to get updates from our router to our Telegram account. But we're gonna do something better. Now here's the real magical part. We're gonna go on GitHub and look up Druvastemma. Okay, so there is this Telegram router OS folder, and inside it, I have saved this Telegram chat resource. That is a script that I've wrote to make it as simple and easy for you to control your router from your Telegram account, almost as if you were directly connected to the CLI. Now, not everything is gonna work. You won't be able to change the directories like you would be able to if you were on a CLI, but pretty much all the commands that you can enter into your CLI, they're gonna work if you enter them into the chat with your bot. So just copy this script. And paste it in the main section of your router. And now we need to go to the script and edit the source. Because obviously the bot token and user IDs are, you know, all just zeros. So we need to replace them with our token and our user ID. Okay, once you've done that, you can just run this script. And what you should see, if you open the Telegram again, and you viewed the chat, you should have received a message saying Telegram script initiated. Once you have received that message, you can start entering CLI commands into this chat and your router will execute them. There is a little bit of a delay because I've set it up to check periodically every 5 seconds. Okay, so it says received IP address print, and then it just prints out line by line the exact same stuff that you would get in a terminal. Okay, interface print. Yep, just printed out the three interfaces that I have on this CHR. So really, I can now chat with my router. I can go, hey router, what's your system resource like? And it will return. And it received the system resource print. Oh, and now it replied, bad command name, resource. I made a typo. So the script didn't break. It just replied the terminal response that you would have got if you typed in a non-existent command. Okay, I started this script manually, and it's also printing out all this stuff that it's doing. So if you're interested in figuring out how this script works, in more detail, this output probably will help you. But of course, you don't want to really be seeing all that. So what I've also created on this GitHub page is another script called Telegram Auto Start. So if you just copy the contents of that script and then paste them into the main section of your router. Why didn't it work? Okay, so I had missed a line when I was uploading the script to the GitHub. I skipped a line, so I'm just gonna need to paste it in System Scheduler, but I'll fix it by the time this video is out. So I should be able to just paste whatever is there into the main section of your router. Okay, so now if I print what's in my scheduler, you can see that there's that it starts on startup, and then every 1 minute it checks if a script named Telegram is running, and if it's not, it starts the Telegram script. So now if I enter system script job and I print, and there is a Telegram script running. If this script were to crash or we were to force stop it, the scheduler will just start it again unless we disable the scheduler. Okay, let's quickly go over the contents of this Telegram script so you can better understand what it's doing. So first we define a few things. The last update ID is where we're gonna store the update ID whenever we read an update, so that when a new update comes out, we know that it came after and we should execute it. The Telegram get updates ID could sometimes return a whole list of updates, and obviously we don't want our script to execute every single command that has been previously stored in this sort of update list. So we can make sure that we only execute the latest update using keeping track of this last update ID. Then obviously there's the bot token, and there's user ID, so that only commands that have been sent from your account get executed by a router. And then I made the send function, which essentially just executes the send message API command. And the most of the important stuff is happening inside a loop where it just executes get updates. It gets the same, pretty much the same data that we got in the browser, except it also uses this offset flag to make sure that only the most recent updates are delivered. And the result is returned as value. Then we further parse it, and we check if this can be trusted. If the sender's ID is that which is stored at the beginning of the script, then the trusted is set to true and the command will be executed. After that, we send a reply that the router has received the command. And then I have used a little trick here where I essentially SSH exec to the router itself. The reason why I do this is so that I can store the output as a variable. RouterOS has a function called execute, but at the time of making this video, it could only store the output as a text file. And we don't want to be storing and erasing a lot of text files inside of our non-volatile memory. So yeah, I decided to use this little hack. But by the time you view this, the exec function might be improved and it might be able to store the output as a variable by then. So feel free to make an improvement here. And then there is a little loop which essentially removes any hashtags from the output that we get from the router, because hashtags are present in the outputs that the router produces. And unfortunately, hashtags cannot be included into the API URL, as it will break everything. After that is done, the reply is split into lines, and then those lines are sent back to the Telegram account one by one. That is all that the script does. But of course, this is not entirely secure. Well, first of all, the access token could be obtained by somebody else, so they could pretend to be your router. But that's not the biggest risk. The bigger risk is that somebody could do a man in the middle for your router, and then they could get your router to do anything they want through this Telegram script. So I created another script that I called Telegram Secure. You can have a look at it on the GitHub page. And the main difference here is that it imports a GoDaddy root certificate. And then when it executes tool fetch, there is also the check certificate equals yes flag. So what this does is prevents man-in-the-middle attacks for the most part. I think that GoDaddy certificate should work for everybody, but in case it doesn't, feel free to replace it with any other certificate authority certificate. Now, I had a lot of fun making this script. I tried to make it as simple, as easy to understand as possible, and I think the result is amazing. But of course, I have a creator's bias here, so if you know a better Telegram script, let us know in the comments. Bye.